Here's a super important concept that we often don't talk about, and that is correcting dogs. We don't want to start correcting dogs too soon because we want to build a relationship before we do that. So there's a simple analogy to that, and that is the piggy bank theory. When we first get our dog and we first start interacting with our dog, we're making deposits into our piggy bank. We're putting a quarter in, we're rewarding the dog. Yes, good boy, yes, good boy, yeah, it's a good boy, good job, I love it, it's great, it's super, you're doing great, because we're not asking the dog to do anything super complex. You make a huge mistake when you try to get your dog to do too much, too fast, because the dog fails. And when the dog fails, he starts to break down because he gets confused. And you have no way of saying to him, hey, it's okay, you just made a little mistake. The dog won't understand that. So the piggy bank theory is the more positive times you make that deposit into the dog's piggy bank, the more times you put a quarter in and a quarter in and a quarter in and a quarter in over a few repetitions, over a few hours of training, over a few days and weeks of training, when you finally give that dog that correction, you tell him, no, knock it off, or no, that's not what I wanted, you're taking a withdrawal. And if you've made enough deposits into the dog's piggy bank, when you take that slight withdrawal out, there's still a really nice, healthy balance in the account. And that balance is his relationship with you. He has seen over and over how he's pleased you, how he's made you happy, how he's gotten you to really be joyous, be excited with him, and all that stuff. Those are all your deposits. The one time you tell him, no, that's not what I wanted, or yuck, fooey, or that's not where we're going, or whatever that is, he's more likely to respond to that with little impact because he has all the deposits that you've put in. So, to sum it up, get your dog and think of him as a piggy bank. And everything you put in that piggy bank should be something positive. So when we're teaching him to follow us, we walk backwards, you give him treats. When he looks at us, we give him treats. When he lies down, we give him treats. These are your deposits. If you're trying to build a savings account, you know you have to put more in than you take out. And when you're training your dog, you're building a savings account. You're building a big savings account with your dog. And you've got to make sure you put more in than you're taking out. So don't start making withdrawals by giving the dog corrections right away. Start by making deposits and getting the dog to understand what he's doing is pleasing you, and the rewards you're giving him are going to pay off with interest in big, big sums later on.